everybody, and let's talk about a little leak that happened yesterday, shall we? So in case you have no idea, and if you don't, I don't know how, you must have avoided the internet, good job you, but there was a leak yesterday of a poster, and this poster, I'm gonna put it on screen right now, is called Destiny Rise of Iron. It's a poster showing the next expansion artwork. Now when this happened, of course, first things first was people were like, is this real? And I think it's pretty much been confirmed, pretty much, that it is real. I mean, just looking at it, the artwork is in line with other Bungie artwork. The spacing of the lettering of Destiny is exactly perfect, and it is a very, very well done, professionally printed art piece. So I think that most of us are inclined to say that yes, Destiny Rise of Iron is real. So in this video, I'm just gonna be going through some things that I've picked up by looking at the poster, and also just going through some things that have been said since the leak came out of what exactly this expansion is going to have in it. So first things first, I want to say, there's wolves, and I know a lot of people might not be excited about this, but I am excited, because if I could get a pet wolf, or if I could fight along wolves, if I'm like a lone soldier, but I'm fighting with wolves, I'm down. That sounds super awesome. Or just finding out about why wolves are so integrated into Iron Banner and the Iron Lords. Like, why are they so integrated in it? We wear wolves on our capes. Although that's kind of mean. I don't want to kill wolves and wear their head on my cape. I don't want to do that. But we have wolves on our capes. We have wolves on, like, our patterns of our armor. What is it with the Iron Lord and wolves? What is it? I want to learn more about that relationship, if not get a pet wolf myself. Okay. So there we go, there's wolves. And that makes me really excited just because there's so much that we can learn about it. Wolves are very integrated into the Iron Banner society, and I would really, really like to know why. Now moving on to some things that more people were excited about, you have Lord Saladin standing in front of a broken wall holding a fiery axe. Now this axe, a few people have said that it looks like the Maul of Thalar's Golden Maul. Is that what it's called? Thalar's Golden Maul. I'll put a picture of that on the screen right now. And that is a thing that is on a Titan mark. Now I don't actually know much about Thalar or who Thalar is, but it could be that Lord Saladin is holding Thalar's Maul. Now, it does say Golden Maul, not Fiery Maul, so it might be a bit of a stretch, but that is the only other piece of art that we have seen that is an axe, like Thalar's axe thing. It's a maul, but we know it as an axe. That's the only thing that we've seen that somewhat looks like an axe. So it could very well be that we have to go and save Thalar's axe because it's been stolen, or maybe Thalar dies and then we take the axe. I don't know. There's so many possibilities. Now, another thing is that I think it's pretty safe to say that this is taking place on Earth. Lord Saladin was part of the Twilight Gap fight. You always hear Shax talk about it. They're always talking about it and going on about it, but he was a part of that fight. So I think it's pretty safe to say that it is Earth. There's also wolves. We haven't really seen wolves be on any other planet, you know? We haven't really seen them on Earth, but I'm gonna say it's Earth, okay? And it's also snowy. We haven't had snow before, so this is making me feel like maybe it's a different part of Earth that we haven't been to before. If that's the case, we're looking at a new patrol area, we're looking at whole new scenery that we have never had in Destiny before, and that makes me super excited. The fact that there's snow and there's wolves, honestly, is like the most exciting thing for me, because it's like, hello, it's snow and it's wolves. Like, forget the fiery axe, it's snow and wolves. That's like a new area, and that's wolves are awesome. Now, the fact that it is on Earth, it has been said in many different articles from quote-unquote respectable or trustworthy sources that there's gonna be a Fallen raid. Now, a new raid has been 100% confirmed by Bungie. If you watched the raid along stream that happened on Wednesday, you will have known that one of the people who designs raids says, can we talk about the new raid? So it has been confirmed that there is definitely 100% a new raid, and it has been said by trustworthy sources that that raid is gonna be a Fallen theme raid, and it's going to be taking place with the Rise of fired. So that's all that we kind of know right now that has been coming from trustworthy sources and that we've looked at the poster and kind of figured out ourselves. But also, one more thing is the size of this expansion. How big is it going to be? It was stated also in this article, the same article that said it would be a Fallen-themed raid, that it's going to be bigger than House of Wolves and Dark Below. It's going to be bigger than those. So I think we're kind of looking at Taken King expansion size, which would be absolutely huge and awesome. Huge and awesome. But with the kind of facts out of the way, I just wanted to talk about some thoughts that I personally have on what could be happening with the Rise of Iron. So first things first, of course, it is about the Iron Lords. It's about Iron Banner. It's about the story of the Iron Banner. We've had Iron Banner since the beta. We have had this event. We've had these weapons that are named after these, like, amazing crucible dudes. We have these things, but we don't really know much about it. Sure, there's lore that you can look at in Grimoire and stuff like that, but in terms of it actually being in the game and knowing their story and knowing what they're all about, we have not had that, but we've had Iron Banner. So I think it's really cool of the possibility that we could be looking at finding out the story of these Iron Lords. Like, if we could see the mighty battles that they were in, if we could see some of those crazy good crucible dudes actually in person and experience their story, that would be absolutely amazing. So what I am personally hoping for on the PvE side, of course, when you talk about Iron Banner at all, you are definitely gonna think about PvP. But what I'm hoping for on the PvE side, of course, is the new raid that is kind of confirmed-ish, because that's gonna be awesome. I love Fallen. I absolutely adore them. I think they're awesome. We haven't seen the House of Kings, so that's going to be really exciting if we can see that in the raid. But also, I would like to see story missions that actually go into Lord Saladin fighting, and what did he do? What kind of battles did he have? And Thalor, and all these other people that we don't really know their story. I would love to have story missions that kind of delve into their story, just so we know more about the Iron Banner, and I think that would be really cool to just find out more. Like, I'm rocking you guys' names on my gun. Why? Who are you? Tell me. Yeah, I want to have story missions that kind of tell me more information about the whole Iron Lords, why they have wolves, who were these people, what were the battles they were involved in. I just want to know more, and I'm really excited for that. Another thing is the fact that it is the Rise of Iron and it is about the Iron Lords. I'm super excited to see what they're going to be bringing to PvP, because it sounds like a pretty big PvP expansion. I might be wrong, but the fact that it is focused on the Crucible, like, the Iron Lords are Crucible dudes. Thalor was an unbeatable titan in the Crucible, like, so it is definitely a very Crucible-oriented expansion, so I'm looking forward to new game modes. Like, some super exciting new game modes would be awesome. I'm also thinking there's a possibility of getting custom matches. Now, I know this is going out on a whim, and a lot of people are gonna be, no, don't even hope for that. Don't even say those words, because it's never gonna happen. But the fact that it is a Crucible-focused expansion, I'm thinking it's a possibility. I know that's kind of me being crazy, but I'm thinking it's a possibility. I might be wrong, like I said, but I'm thinking it's a possibility. I think it's more likely that we would get custom matches over getting a ranked playlist, which makes me kind of sad, because honestly, I would love to have a ranked playlist. I think that would be amazing. But I think that getting custom matches is within a reasonable expectation, kind of. Now, I'm gonna get a little crazy. You thought custom games was crazy. I'm gonna get a little insane. So, the fiery axe, yeah? There's a fiery axe. This could be a number of things. This could be a new weapon that's being added, like a sword. It could be something that we just get to use in a story mission. It could be a relic, like maybe it just drops in the world and we can pick it up. Kind of like the rocket was in House of Wolves. Kind of like that. But what if the fiery axe is an indication that there's going to be subclasses. So what I mean by that is, you know how we have solar titans and they have hammers? What if there's gonna be, okay, you can choose your solar titan. Do you wanna have the hammer super, or do you wanna have the axe super? And it will act differently, of course. It's gonna be different to hammers. But it will be slightly different. It will have slightly different subclass grenades and stuff like that. And if that's the case, it means that world warlocks and hunters would also get subclasses. Now, I don't know if that could be correct, but I would not be surprised if subclasses were mixed up a little bit. I wouldn't be surprised if they kind of changed the way that subclasses are and gave us a new super within the Hunter, Warlock, and Titan. It might not be a new element because I'm pretty sure we're set in those elements, at least until Destiny 2, but maybe it could be like a new weapon or something. Maybe Hunters can get like, I don't know, a sword? Or maybe nunchucks? I don't know. But you guys know where I'm going with this, right? You kind of understand what I'm saying. That is super exciting. That thought makes me super duper excited. Honestly, the possibilities for Rise of Iron are absolutely endless. That's why on the Planet Destiny podcast, it was like 3 hours long. Because there's just so many possibilities that could be happening with the Crucible with the Rise of Iron. But I'm gonna leave it there. We talked about it a lot last night. If you guys do want to check out the Planet Destiny podcast, I will leave a link in the description. But that's it for this video. Let me know in the comments section, what are you excited for with Rise of Iron? What are the possibilities that you are most excited for? I am hyped! I'm excited. My headphones just fell off. That's how excited I am. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. I'll speak to you awesome people later. Bye.